My name is Stefan Henrich. I studied architecture, so basically I'm a trained architect. I have a small office in Stuttgart, in which we are here right now. It's called Stefan Henrich, Robotic Design und Architektur. And this is exactly what I do, robotics, design and architecture. So I try to link these fields, to combine them, to create design. In architecture, things shouldn't move. They should be static. And I always found this is a pity. And I was missing something during my study. So early on, I started to be interested in and to invent things that are allowed to move. So I'm interested in seats that move, tables that move, light installations that are simply infected by robotics, if you want. I think additive technologies go very well together with movable parts. That's also maybe the reason why 3D printing gave me the second big freedom in design in my practice. The first one would be 3D modeling. Once it's in your head, you give it to the computer and you have shapes and stuff that in this case float around. And then to freedom, yeah, you need something which is more powerful, more mighty than a laser cutting device or a milling device. And 3D printing technology was pretty much the enabler to allow me to go further, to go deeper to this kind of design. Yeah. So why is selective laser sintering interesting? Of course, in comparison to other 3D printing technologies, you have incredible construction freedom. Moving parts and many moving parts become plausible. For example, this part here, I designed for actually the table we are sitting on. Yeah, it's moving in two areas here, and here's a third part moving within. It's built in one shot, so there's no assembly. That's also an advantage maybe. The way I use it is not to represent parts that are done then afterwards in conventional technology or in alternative technologies. So I'm interested in producing functional endparts that are stable enough to survive our usage. That became my home to find to design an SLS.